So you may have the secret to who murdered Deborah H?
Yes.
Well, if the lad's innocent, I hope that it clears him.
Having his phone ring at odd times is nothing unusual for veteran barrister Kevin Borick.
About Deborah Leach.
However, rarely, if ever, does a call come at such a moment and after so many years. Had you ever had anything like this happen to you before?
Never.
The caller was Alan Brown, and he was about to deliver a bombshell.
I contacted the lawyer.
Kevin Borick?
Kevin Borick, yes. And offered the information what I had.
The surprise call was prompted by media coverage of the appeal Kevin Borick was running before the High Court in June over the 1971 murder of 15-year-old Deborah Leach on Taparoo Beach.
Totally unexpected. I was sitting in my house, I was watching the television.
And so all this time, you've had that memory, but it's been locked away in your mind.
Yes.
Just 2 days earlier, Kevin Borick had asked the High Court to find the time of death evidence in the historic case had misled the jury, leading to Fritz van Beelen's conviction for the killing of Deborah 5 decades ago. Now a phone call could change everything.
I saw a girl walking down the path, just about to step over onto the sand.
And did you recognise that person?
Yes. Yes, I recognised her as Deborah Leach.
Deborah Leach, the schoolgirl.
The schoolgirl, yes.
Which is very significant in terms of the legal situation in this case at the moment.
Van Beelen's fate had largely rested on timing. The Crown's evidence from forensic pathologist Dr. Colin Manock was that Deborah must have been dead by 4:30 p.m., absolutely no later.
They could not convict him if she was alive after 4:30 because he had to have left the beach at 4:30.
Both sides had accepted that that afternoon he'd left Taparoo and picked up his wife around 5 p.m. from her work at the GPO in the city, a trip of about 25 to 30 minutes. And now to Alan Brown's sighting. What time do you think this would have occurred?
About 4:45.
4:45.
So, in the afternoon.
Yeah. Alan, who was 17, says he recalls the time because his job was to deliver groceries for the local Coles supermarket and he had to return by 5 p.m. for his final load.
We'd finished the delivery down south and second to last delivery was on Lady Gowrie Drive at Taparoo. And we pulled up and delivered to that address.
And that street fronts the beach, I take it?
That's right, yes.
He pulled up and unloaded the groceries on the beach side of his van. That's when he saw Deborah. But he says she was not alone. Aside from her dog, there was someone else on the beach.
Approaching her, heading south, was a fellow who I recognised, and he was walking straight towards her.
As if he was intending to meet her?
That's right, yes. Oh, I knew who he was, because you got to know people in the area.
And who was this gentleman?
His name was Lou Muller.
What did you know of Lou Muller?
What I knew of him at the time, he used to have a wrecking yard up there on Osborne Road at Osborne. And he was known in the area as not, he didn't have a very good personality. He was known as not a very nice person.
That name has not arisen before. During their early investigations, police located a man with a limp thought to have been in the area at the time. Their immediate suspect was quickly discounted. But now, there's a second possibility.
Was there something, anything distinctive about Lou Muller that you noticed?
Yes, he used to walk with a distinctive limp or a gait.
Of course, most of this Alan could have gleaned from media reports. All we know is that this was Mr. Muller's wrecking yard as it appeared in 1971. It did exist, but he has since passed away.
And I was listening to his story. It did sound credible.
Kevin Borick's next step was a hurriedly convened meeting with Van Beelen's solicitor, Michael Hegarty, and an attempt to piece together and verify Alan's movements and recollections.
When did you find out that there had been the death of the young girl on the beach?
Yeah, it was the following day.
So that would have reinforced your memory?
That's right, yeah.
Okay.
And Alan says once he saw that, he went straight to the police.
I went to the Port Adelaide police station and saw a officer, and I told him I'd like to give some information about the Taproot Beach murder, and they took my name and address and telephone number and said someone will contact me to take a statement, which they never did.
So the police didn't follow up?
No.
It was clear at the time police knew they didn't have the whole story. They certainly didn't have Alan's.
Inspector Giles said there were other people who he knew were on the beach but had not come forward.
And yet here's Alan Brown, who did come forward.
Not referred to.
And not questioned.
That's right. It's extraordinary.